Here's a little tutorial on how I installed the Stone Backsplash for my best friend. Let's start from the very beginning on the job site.
We're gonna have open shelving, two of them here, this corner, and this corner here. So in addition to putting in the countertops, add in the open shelving, we are going to be adding this stone for backsplash. How pretty is that? So that being said though, the stone is super heavy, so we cannot have it just on drywall. So the goal today is to remove all the drywall that's up now and then put on cement board. Let's do it.
This process of removing the drywall honestly was pretty easy, but it definitely is a crucial step as the stone itself is super heavy, so you have to have it on cement board, and it definitely helped that we could also then attach the brackets for the open shelving directly to the studs.
Okay, so drywall is removed. We went through and scored where we are gonna be removing drywall and up at the top, just so if it was, you know, tape on the corners, you didn't want that to pull on the ceiling, and then demoed it. Now we're just taking out all the screws, and Noah got started on hanging the brackets for the floating shelves because these are gonna be onto the studs so that we're gonna put cement board over top of these.
We just got these shelf brackets from Amazon. However, any local hardware store probably has them too. We tried to install enough shelf brackets so that the weight was distributed evenly throughout the shelves. After all the shelf brackets were installed, we then began cutting our cement board. We used a grinder to cut the cement board to the correct size, and we also used a grinder to cut out any of the spots for the outlets. We also had to cut out all of the holes for our floating shelves, and for that we used a paddle bit attached to a drill. And I'm not gonna lie, this process was a bit tedious, just making sure that all of our measurements were correct. We then unscrewed all of the light switches as well as outlets so that we could pull them through the cement board. We then slid the cement board into place and then attached the cement board to the studs using decking screws. The reason we use decking screws is because they are stronger than drywall screws and they're definitely more resistant to moisture.
Okay, so the other week we were here and you saw us installing the concrete board. We're back again today. We're gonna finish installing the rest of the concrete board because this weekend we're gonna start on the backsplash. But since I was here last time, the countertops got installed. I am obsessed.
Just so pretty. And then she did a waterfall edge on the front. I'm obsessed.
And these are gonna look so good with the stone backsplash. So we are going to be putting up the rest of the concrete board, and we are also going to put in the floating shelves today.
For our floating shelves, we use some 2x12 pine. We pre-cut this at our house and actually also cut these little slits with a biscuit joiner as well. I'll explain that process a little later. We then measured inside the kitchen to see exactly where the brackets would line up on the shelves and marked that out exactly on the pine. We then used a doweling jig that was exactly the same size as the brackets that we had already installed in the kitchen, lined that up exactly where we had marked out, and then attached it with a screw so that it wouldn't move. You'll see Noah's using two pieces of cloth to hold it exactly into place because after drilling on it once, the friction causes that piece to get extremely hot. Once the doweling jig was secured, we then used a Forstner bit to cut a hole for the exact size of the bracket. From there, we then slid the shelf into place onto the brackets. And now I'll explain why we used the biscuit joiner. So you'll see that we have the biscuit joiner on the two ends where the shelves are going to meet. We want to make sure that the shelves don't move and that they're held together. The biscuit joiner is going to help with that process, but the first thing we had to do was cut a groove into the end of the other shelf so that it could easily slide into place. Then added our wood biscuits into the other end and slid it into place as well as onto the bracket so that it was super secure. Once all of our shelves were installed, we then applied some stain, and then we were ready to start on our stone backsplash. First thing first, we had to prep all of the cement board. We had to use cement tape to cover up all of the seams and then apply a thin coat of mortar. And after all of that was dry, we were then ready to start installing our stone backsplash. We used a wet sponge to wetten our cement board before we applied our mortar. We apply the mortar to the cement board as well as the back of the stones. Doing this is going to give you better adhesion. If you remember, the stone that I showed at the beginning of this video came in sections. However, I found that that stone was extremely heavy and I actually preferred for it to be more of a random pattern. So we used a grinder to cut all of the wiring backing off the back of the stones and hung them individually. honestly, this whole process was a little bit of a puzzle. I think the biggest thing is just making sure that you work in small sections. The mortar does dry pretty quickly, but it definitely helps if you wetten your cement board beforehand. For the most part, the stones stayed in place as I hung them. However, a few were a bit heavy, and in those areas, I made sure to use some spacers for support. After letting all of the stones set for one day, I then went in, removed all of my spacers, and then began filling all of the grout lines. I used the same exact mortar that I used underneath the stones to fill all of my grout lines. However, this time we mixed it up to a little bit thinner of a consistency. Then using a piping bag and a wet sponge and gloves, I then began to fill all of the spacing in between the stones. Because some of these gaps were so large, I found it really easy to go in, pipe in between the stones, and then let it sit for about 10 minutes before going back with a wet sponge. Once I went back in with the wet sponge, I simply was just smearing around the mortar. You want it to be a smooth finish, but you also don't need it to be perfect. We're going for a German smear look, so it's actually preferable if you get a little bit of the mortar over top of the stone. The mortar itself will dry a little lighter and gives it somewhat of a whitewash finish. And I'm not gonna lie, this process was a bit messy, but it's totally worth it. And after a little dry time and a good cleaning, this kitchen was officially finished. This was a lot of hard work, but it was definitely worth it. I am absolutely in love with this German smear stone look. Hopefully you found this tutorial super helpful and it gives you the inspiration to create this same backsplash in your own kitchen. For a written tutorial, as well as a list of materials and supplies used, you can check out our blog at www.thegibbyhome.com. Also, be sure to follow us on TikTok and Instagram at thegibbyhome.